what we're trying to depict is the decay of a Higgs boson to two Z bosons.
That's the way to think about it, sure. Because what's happening is
this is the easiest way to sort of brainstorm.
And then that photon might split into like an electron positron pair, and then
you know, we have the physics and we have kind of the concept of how it should look and how it should go and data.
Each one, each track would essentially end in this sort of lightning bolt.
Yeah, it ends in like the lightning bolt type of shower thing.
But you know, it comes down to we need to actually fill the space with paint. So you know, we spent a long time trying to just to decide on what color. We decided a warm kind of red and yellow had just seemed like they're associated with energy. Or you see atomic bombs and you see fire and
like you should look at it and you should just be like, whoa, that's just
energy.
Yeah, it's just energy and nothing more. And it is very violent and it's very chaotic, like the type of environment where these collisions happen. I mean, there's no one within 100 meters of the detector when they're making these collisions because you get radiation poisoning and die.
It is a shift. Usually I have some sort of model. I look at something and I analyze it. So in this case,
it'll fragment.
So. The model is just kind of a discussion or data, what Sam says, how it should look.
They do is they spit off these things that we call gluons.
So I say okay, and then I make a line, and then we kind of analyze it through that.
This could go. Yeah, you don't need to see
that. Yeah, it could, but then we would lose the ability.
I think it's important to have interesting looking images for the public.
When you're trying to visualize what's actually happening, I guess you stretch in different ways and there's a chance that you'll make a somersault in your mind into thinking about it in a different way.